Hola, I haven't made a video in a long time. Sorry about that if you're the one person that cares. But I'm back. And I promise I'm gonna be making more videos from now on because I'm moving. I'm not gonna have roommates. So I don't feel like a crazy weirdo every time I do this. In the future, hopefully. I've been watching Dexter. Binge watching Dexter. It took me about 3 weeks to fucking watch Dexter from season 1 to 8 the whole time, knowing he's not gonna die because the title of the show is Dexter. It's not gonna be Deborah. Dexter's not the best show to binge watch because most of the whole anti-hero premise depends on the thrill and the suspense of not knowing if this person's gonna make it to the next episode and to the next season. And you know Dexter's gonna survive in Dexter. But if you're willing to overlook that, yeah, definitely you fall in love with Dexter. And I don't know if that's good that we're all falling in love with a serial killer who happens to be a gentleman in every other area of his life except, you know, killing. Let me talk about what I loved about Dexter first. I loved Dexter and his dark passenger. We all have dark passenger, a side of us that we don't want to see, that we think is the worst part of us, that holds us back from everything that we could accomplish if we just didn't have that dark passenger in us. And I mean, this show is no Breaking Bad. No show pre-Breaking Bad will ever be better than Breaking Bad in terms of, you know, anti-hero themes, etc. But it's pretty good. It's pretty close to great. If it wasn't for all the times that he gets away with things that because the police is lazy or... See, the bad thing about binge-watching a show is that you don't really remember what happens from one episode to the other. You just kind of ride the wave. And I don't know if the police, like, if they show the cops dealing with every situation that Dexter stopped and killed the suspect. Like, I don't know if they ever dealt with that or if the writers just didn't think anybody would care that most of the time it's like, you know, the guy's dead and then what happens? Like, the cops never question what happens. I'm kind of glad that I don't remember because I binge watch, because imagine going from week to week with that frustration of like, how can they not see? It's Dexter. It's right next to you in that lab, playing with blood, looking at people's DNA. I mean, nobody ever thinks to seize his computer. I mean, it just makes no sense. He never wears a hairnet, and you don't ever find a hair. I mean, they all talk about microscopic particles and fibers being able to be found with, you know, tape, but they never find a clothing fiber. They never find one of the fiber of his boots or of his hair. I mean, this show is supposed to be rooted in reality, so, you know, I can only suspend my belief so much. I'm really glad I don't remember half of the things that happened because it would piss me off even more. And not to mention the terrible... Okay, somehow I crossed into the things that I hate when I was talking to the things... Well, the things that I love. Sorry about that. But, I'm sorry, I really hated the ending of the show. Like, when I watched Breaking Bad, I hated the ending of the show because it wasn't what I was looking for. But watching Dexter and how it ended, maybe I appreciated Breaking Bad and how it ended because that's the way I would have wanted Walter White to die. That's the way Walter White would have wanted the end to be, you know? And I can appreciate that. And Dexter made me realize that because the ending was so not true to Dexter as a character. He would have never left his son. He spent, like, 6 seasons or 7 seasons or something looking after his son, getting into so many tight situations to protect his son and the relationship, that you think he's just gonna send him off to Argentina? Come on! And the worst betrayal of all, you had to kill Deborah? Like, she didn't do a goddamn thing. Leave her out of it, you fucking fuck. But you know what? In the midst of watching the show, you let it go. You let it all go because you can see the struggle that Dexter's having with morality and how to fit in into what's considered normal in society. And because he has no feelings, he's always trying to mask that part of himself. And you relate, I mean, I relate to that, at least. Trying to pretend like you're not an outsider in certain situations. And so you let it go, because you just enjoy seeing this man struggle through the moral code he's been taught and the one that he wants to develop himself, which is like growing up. But then you gotta go give me a fucking lumberjack at the end? Come on! I mean, it felt like a slap in the face. It was so anticlimactic. I hate to say I could have stopped watching, but I actually could have, because I didn't even like the last season. I've never wanted Dexter to kill anyone so badly as that fucking beautiful, powerful, feminist icon bitch. If anybody could look up to Hannah, whatever her name was, Hannah McKay or something, I goddamn fucking hated her. And you know, you can never trust her, and you're gonna tell me that he's gonna send Harrison with a bitch you can't trust? I hadn't gotten so much into a show until, well, I mean, besides Orphan Black a few weeks ago, but that's over. Oh, I hate when your favorite show has like a bad ending, and pretty much I feel like all the things I love have bad endings. Like, I didn't like the Harry Potter ending. I can deal with it, but I don't like it. But one of the things that I most loved about Dexter was just, all that I love about any anti-hero story is that, like, you have the opportunity to enter into a mind, into a life you're never gonna live. You can even, you know, get, like, fictionally attached to a serial killer. Like, that is amazing. I mean, you can write a show that people will root for a serial killer. And I especially loved that Dexter is a geek. To an outsider, it comes off as him being a geek, which he kind of is when it comes to blood spatter analysis. But it's just him, you know, it's just him kind of peeping into that forbidden world that consumes so much of him. And, you know, the killing, the pain, the blood, there's such a big theme of blood because he was found in his mother's pool of blood. And oh my god, when he found Rita in the bathtub and Harrison in the blood, oh my god. Like, you know when you watch a show and the image sticks in your brain, that image will always stay with me. Just him finding the baby in the blood. I mean, that was the most painful moment. Like, that, you want a climax like that to be the ending of Dexter, but you get a fucking lumberjack instead. Something else that I loved about the show was like the representation of the genders. Like, whereas you get Dexter, who's like this macho, in a way, he's like this macho archetype, but he's also like a gentleman and he wants to be a good father, a good husband. So that's kind of like, you know, has a little bit of like the yin and yang kind of metaphor or whatever. I don't understand that comparison, but, and then you get somebody like Deborah, who's a girl, but you know, she's like a tough girl, she cusses a lot, she's a cop, she's wearing cowboy boots and jeans most of the time. Like, it was so cool, and it was so awesome that there was so much Spanish and like recognition of the presence of Cuban culture in Miami. I thought that was so cool because most shows won't show you that. Most shows are very much like, we're white people and here's the one black person and the one Hispanic person on the show, and they rarely ever discuss any like, or mirror any kind of like real issue going on in the outside world. So I thought that was really cool and like forward thinking of the writers. Oh, and I kind of appreciated the Lumen storyline, but only because it's Julia Stiles and she's from 10 Things I Hate About You, and I love that film. And also, you love to think that a woman could love Dexter for all that he is, blah blah blah. But then when we saw it with Hannah, I was like, ugh, whatever, you're a poisoner, go away. But I think what fascinated me the most about this show was like the flashbacks you have of Dexter growing up and kind of learning the code from his dad and seeing the discrepancy between his thoughts and what other people consider normal and what they would expect you as a normal, empathetic human being to feel. And I had that same morbid fascination in Harry Potter when you see Voldemort be a child and you already see the I don't want to say the bad because, see, it's like, I can't even think of Dexter as being bad. It's like, but he is bad, he's a killer, but we are so, so attached and sympathetic of Dexter that we're willing to put him in a different category, you know, like a vigilante almost, even though he's not. And even if he was a vigilante, if you want to call him a vigilante, you're still a bad person if you kill. I mean, at least, like, I think you're not the greatest person if you kill. I didn't necessarily like Harris, like the Harris part, like him talking to Harris, although, yeah, it was cool, but it was like, at one point, I like didn't even notice that he was still there in season 8 until I went on IMDb and it was like, he was on all the episodes. I was like, you were on all the episodes? Like, I know in the season, he's like, you don't need me anymore, son. But, like, you're in all the episodes? I don't think we need Harris for all the episodes. But anyway, yeah, I missed out on Dexter when I was on. I mean, I walked into a person watching an episode of Dexter, and it was like Dexter just having, like, this long monologue, and I didn't get it. Because, you know, when you don't watch the show from the first episode, you don't get it. And so that put me off from Dexter for a long time until I don't have any other anti-hero to watch because Orphan Black has been done for like 3 weeks now and I already watched Orange is the New Black too many times. So I was like, fuck it, I'll watch Dexter. I loved it. I give 5 stars on fucking Netflix. I don't think I would re-watch because the whole... What keeps me there was the suspense, and yeah, I love like the writing of the dialogue / monologues, but I don't think I would want to watch Dexter again, cause I can put up with the other bullshit, but I just can't even take that image of the lumberjack and disappointment that overcame me at that moment in time. But anyway. Thank you for watching if you still are. I think next time I see you, or that you see me, actually, next time you see me, I'm probably gonna be in a new place. Not too far from here, it's just in the back. But I'll see you till then. Let me know what you thought of Dexter. Let me know what other show I could watch that's like Dexter. I'm watching Hemlock Grove in Netflix. I don't know what the hell the premise is. Like, I'm on like episode 9 or 8 or something, and I still don't know what it is about. Like, I don't know if it's like the binge watching memory loss, or like if that's the point of the show, or maybe I'm just not paying attention. Because I still don't know what's going on. I know there's a werewolf, and then there's like the weird mind controlling, nose bleeding people. And someone's killing the girls, and I still don't get how they go together. Anyway, this video is taking too long. It's going off topic. Goodbye.